greetings. Whether a person is Muslim or Jewish, Christian or Buddhist, we seek to respect the writings and the scriptures before us, and we seek to understand their meaning, or what they thought they, the authors, were communicating. That is simply an issue with all written text. I have a favorite example to demonstrate this perfectly. The example is not of my own creation. I got it from some motivational speaker. A simple sentence with only 7 words. A statement with 7 different meanings based on the one word emphasized. I didn't say you took that money. This simple sentence may have 7 different meanings, simply changing which word is emphasized. I didn't say you took that money. This implies someone else made the accusation you took that money. I didn't say you took that money. This flat out denies that you made an accusation, assuming one was made. I didn't say you took that money. This implies you made the accusation in some other nonverbal form. I didn't say you took that money. This implies you accused someone else of taking the money. I didn't say you took that money. This implies you accused them of doing something besides taking the money. I didn't say you took that money. Here we have accused them of taking some other money, just not this money in question. I didn't say you took that money. This makes accusation of taking something else besides the money. Same sentence with 7 different meanings, simply changing which word is emphasized. Can you begin to grasp the difficulty of preserving meaning in text? It gets worse, however, when each word has more than one meaning. And now imagine an ancient language with cultural meaning lost to history. This truly is the challenge anyone faces leaving a text to be read hundreds of years after the author is not available. The reasonable approach we must take is to aggregate and harmonize. For any given topic, assume all scriptures which mention a topic apply equal insight and detail to the topic. This is the aggregation portion of the study. How many scriptures talk about marriage, for example? Aggregation identifies all the verses and passages dealing with a certain topic. Harmonization is the next step, looking for an interpretation that best agrees with all scriptures. And that is a reasonable approach that attempts to pay respect to the whole counsel of the scriptures. But there is a major religion where this is explicitly undermined. In Islam, the author of the Quran has explicitly created a doctrine called abrogation. Abrogation explicitly creates a sequential hierarchy by replacement. By itself, it is not a fatal flaw, per se. The Bible also contains a concept of gradual revelation. Abrogation does complicate the harmonization process which Muslims must apply. The other issue is consistent application during harmonization. Whatever the religion, and whoever the follower, whatever standard they apply to their scripture, to be honest, they must apply the same to other texts. If you are Christian, always apply the same logic against the Bible as you apply against the Quran. Don't ever be afraid to do so, because God's word can pass any test. But also, don't let a Muslim attack with one standard they refuse to apply against the Quran. Apply an even scale. Proverbs 11:1, the Lord detests the use of dishonest scales, but he delights in accurate weights. Leviticus 19:35, do not use dishonest standards when measuring length, weight, or quantity. I think measuring logic and truth are obvious extensions. Leviticus 19:36, use honest scales and honest weights, an honest ephah and an honest hin. I am the Lord your God who brought you out of Egypt. Deuteronomy 25:13, do not have two differing weights in your bag, one heavy and one light. For the Lord your God detests anyone who does these things, anyone who deals dishonestly. Proverbs 16:11, honest scales and balances belong to the Lord. All the weights in the bag are of his making. Proverbs 20:10, differing weights and differing measures, the Lord detests them both. Proverbs 20:23, the Lord detests differing weights and dishonest scales do not please him. Hosea 12:7, the merchant uses dishonest scales and loves to defraud. Defrauding is a form of theft. Theft and stealing are both condemned and forbidden. You know that, right? Just asking. And that is the aggregation phase of a brief study of honest standards. This was a relatively simple example for the harmonization process. These verses specifically speak of physical measurement and financial dealings. How much more do you think God values honest thinking and judgments? I'm thinking that to a God who cannot lie, a God who is the truth, honest judgment, truthful judgment, is near and dear to his heart. I think that honest aggregation and harmonization can lead us to the truth of even written text. In part two, I would like to continue the discussion of harmonization issues before delving into some heavy examples. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.